March 14, 2014, 10 a.m. now, this schnauzer had a very bad body odor and very bad infection and very painful left ear due to the hairy ears and lack of ventilation and drainage. Finally, the owner has decided on this surgery called lateral ear canal resection. The dog is now around 20 hours after surgery by Dr. Daniel Singh, and as you can see, there is a horizontal canal opening, and this is the drainage cartilage flap, and this is 20 hours after surgery. So far so good, the stitches are holding. I did sedate the dog to get the ear washed because it was quite bloody. Now this surgery is quite effective for dogs with hairy ears, and most Singapore owners are unaware of this surgery, or they are not willing to pay for the cost, which is around $800 for the surgery anesthesia. In this surgery, which you can see from the book, the veterinary surgery book by Fossum, the lateral wall is cut out, and then you get the exposure of the opening of the horizontal canal. Hold this. So, go to the side. So once you, I'm asking my assistant to hold this so that I can explain. So first of all, you cut the skin, the incision. Then after that, then you open up to expose the cartilage, open the rectangular flap. Then thirdly, you cut the canal. Cut the canal, as you can see. Then the lateral wall, the cartilage is pulled downwards. Expose the opening of the horizontal canal opening, as you can see from here. After that, you stitch up the lower flap, which you cut. You cut about 2 centimeters, and then you stitch up the drainage cartilage where you can see the horizontal canal opening. Now, there's something wrong with this. This camera can't focus properly. Now it focus, okay. So you can see the horizontal canal opening. I start from the beginning of the surgery from Fossum, veteran surgery textbook. You're supposed to mark, use a marker pen to mark the area. Then after that, you cut the skin up and leave it upwards to expose the lateral wall, the cartilage. Then the third one, under C, you cut the sides of the vertical canal. Then under D, you pull down the side wall of the lateral canal and cut the lower end. You cut the lower end so that there is a drainage board. So the drainage board is stitched up, and as you can see, the horizontal canal opening, so everything can drain out. So there is no more obstruction, and no more water trapped, and there is ventilation. So now I show you the actual surgery. Now, actual surgery is this. You can see from the dog. Here is the dog. This one is 20 hours old. So you can see the horizontal canal. Horizontal canal. The flap, the cartilage flap, drainage flap. Horizontal canal. And upper this vertical canal has been opened up. There used to be a wall here. Canal was cut open. This is the cartilage, and the dog is on painkillers, that's why it's not painful. Otherwise, it would be quite painful. Painkillers. painkillers will be given for 4 to 5 days. Now the dog cannot go home because the owner can't look after it. Now this surgery, I noticed, is quite well done. As you can see the horizontal canal is open up. And also because the owner has not delayed too long, so that the whole horizontal canal is still quite open, clear, and it's not full of polyps and lumps and bumps, as in the case of dogs with long-standing chronic ear infections of over 5 years to 10 years. This dog is about 5 years old, and the main complaint was, of course, the body odor. The body is very smelly, and nobody dares to go near him. But most likely the cause could be due to the infection that passed from inside the ear canal. Now you can see the horizontal canal is quite big in this case, so I would say this surgery is quite successful. Now we look at the other side, we turn the other side, and you can see the same, turn back, you can see that the horizontal canal is also quite open up, and the vertical canal has been removed, the side wall of the vertical canal has been removed, showing the opening of the vertical horizontal canal. So this dog's ears is like a human ear, so it can drain out easily. Water and air can ventilate this horizontal canal now, so there's no more trapping of dirt, water and hairs. Because schnauzers have hairy ears, so all these hairy ears trap water and causes ulceration in the vertical canal and horizontal canal. So the dog keeps scratching and then damage the whole neck and also the body. Sometimes it bites the body because there's a itch. When the dog's ear is itchy, the dog will use the leg to scratch. And then damage the skin. The skin get infected and the dog feels more itchy, so it scratch more. See, it scratch more, and all this area become infected by bacteria, and then it bites here as well. And especially the neck, it was bad last time. Hold the neck up, the neck was bad last time. The dog was on 2 weeks of medication before this surgery. Don't do the surgery immediately because the ear canal is fully infected. March 14, 2014, lateral ear canal resection, 20 hours after surgery. The dog has been sedated and given the, has been washed clean so that there's no more blood on the surgical area. The healing should be quite good. Dog is on antibiotics and painkillers, a rare e-collar, and be hospitalized for a few days, maybe 4 days. Okay, end of video.